Did you happen to notice the CDC put out a thing the other day about zombies? Well, what you gotta worry about is not the zombies. It's the people that's not gonna have the food to eat. So, stop and think about this. I'm going to put some clips up along with this video so you can see what I'm talking about. They're not going to be actual zombies, but it's going to be pretty much like 28 Days Later or Zombieland. Make sure and stock up on your food. Make sure and try to grow your own food. Make sure and have water, plenty of water. You can't ignore that. Water is pretty key. So look at the clip, see what you think about it.
Fox News alert on the world food supplies. We have been tracking this story for a few days now, and it is getting quite some attention. Food supplies getting very tight. And on the commodity markets, food prices soaring to levels never before seen. It's been gradually showing up in our supermarkets, and you're going to pay for it in your pocketbook. And Fox Business Network's Eric Bolling has been warning about this and now says it could get much worse. We had you on 2 weeks ago.
Remember
with
these?
The corn
Yeah, remember this?
And it's happening. What exactly is happening globally that is affecting us in our local supermarket?
Yeah, we're having a confluence of bad things going on right now. Our supplies are already low of food, corn, rice, coffee, sugar, wheat. Supplies low. Now we're finding out the USDA tells us that, guess what, the crops that we're expecting to come out in the next, at least the two harvests, may be light as well, which means prices are on the rise, all coupled with, I don't know if you watch it, at the bottom of the screen once in a while you see an oil price go by, $92 a barrel, $91.48 right now as we speak. Those prices are going up. Here's the issue, Megan, when corn prices went up, when rice and wheat prices went up 2 years ago in 2008, it sparked food riots. Now, that was on the heels of $147 barrel of oil, $4 gasoline. We're only, when I say only, I mean only in relationship to 147, we're only at $92 a barrel. If we were to go back to $147 a barrel like last time, that would push all these prices 60% higher. That's a big problem because these prices are high right now on the wholesale level. They're making their way to the supermarket. Go to the supermarket.
And the thing is, they're not only talking about higher prices, which is a big enough concern, but they're also talking, the World Economic Forum apparently warning that a rising global population, greater prosperity, are putting unsustainable pressure on resources. And they say, Eric, we could be looking at the specter of shortages, which could lead to social, political instability, geopolitical conflict, and irreparable environmental damage. I mean, this is something that could affect us on many levels.
Will affect us. You see this, I'm holding up rice right here, because in 2008, when oil went to $147 a barrel, rice prices spiked to $25 per 100 metric tons. They're right now around 20. If we were to see that again last time, the food riots that you saw on the side of the screen a little while ago would pale in comparison this time, because people aren't as well off. The last time this happened was on the heels of a very robust world economy. We're not there right now. Megan, they were actually giving out cards, credit cards, to buy rice so people wouldn't starve. It's a bad situation, getting worse, and if we do, if the globe does grow, like you mentioned, it's only going to push prices substantially.
And now
higher.
They're also talking about this flooding in Australia, where there's apparently a lot of cattle ranches that have been affected by the flooding.
Right.
And so now importers here in the United States that rely on that meat to fill orders for restaurants and so on are saying they're going to have to look elsewhere. And that may cause some problems because, you know, there's been some problems with importing meat from other places like South America. So now Americans could be affected in more ways than they know.
Let me show
One of the critical elements in launching a weatherized balance is being able to control rain and unleash floods.
The military have had a keen interest in the weather basically since day one. There have been a number of times the military have actually succeeded in developing technology to use the weather.
In history, there is a chilling example of a flood that may have been accidentally triggered with a weather weapon. August 15th, 1952. Near the small town of Lynmouth, England, a massive rainstorm strikes. The river swells. Scores die.
It's estimated that 250 times as much rain fell in a period of 24 hours as normally fell in the entire month.
The East Lynn and West Lynn rivers flood their banks. According to the BBC, 90 million tons of water sweep down into the town of Lynmouth.
35 people were killed.
Bodies wash out to sea and are never found. Trees are uprooted, forming dams behind bridges, creating walls of water that carry huge boulders into the village, destroying shops, hotels, and homes. Was this just a freak act of nature? The prevailing theory is that it may have been a British military experiment gone bad, as they had been known to be conducting cloud seeding tests around that same time.
The British military would be experimenting with cloud seeding for the same reason as any government or military, because if you can control the weather, if you can make it rain, you can have a profound effect on the battlefield.
Allegedly, early on the morning of August 15, 1952, some witnesses had reported seeing Royal Air Force jets flying in the area, at times disappearing from sight high above the cloud deck. Were they on a routine training mission? Or, as some people speculate, were they dumping payloads of silver iodide into the clouds? Silver iodide is one of the most common chemicals used for cloud seeding. It forces the tiny ice crystals that make up the cloud to fuse together. Once enough tiny ice crystals fuse together, they become heavy and fall to the earth in the form of rain.
That looks like a piece of a house.
Sorry.